first medals. Now, what we are going to see is in class 7, chapter 4, simple equations, exercise 4.1, question number 3. What is the question in the sense? Solve the following equations by trial and error method. What do you mean by trial and error method? We are going to try with some numbers by assumption on our own. And if it is error, we are going to try again and again. That is trial and error method. Okay. Let us solve the question now. The question number 3, first subdivision is 5p plus 2z equal to 17. We are going to substitute the values of p on our own and we are going to check whether this is a true solution or not. Okay, 5p. What is the symbol in between 5 and p? It's nothing but multiplication. If you substitute p is equal to 1, then we will get, instead of p, we are going to substitute 1 in the place of p. So what will you get? 5 into 1. So I have given one bracket here. If it is in the bracket, it means that it is in multiplication. 5 into 1 plus 2 is equal to 17. I haven't changed anything else. In the place of p, I have written 1 and remaining thing, it comes as such. Can you understand, students? So 5 into 1 plus 2 is equal to 17. 5 ones are 5. 5 plus 2 is equal to 17. 5 plus 2 we get 7. Is 7 equal to 17? No, it is not equal. Therefore, this will not be a solution for the given equation. So we tried but we got error answer. So we are going to try with some other value. Okay, so p is equal to 2. If you substitute this, 5 into 2 plus 2 is equal to 17. 5 2s are what we get? 10. 10 plus 2 is 17, but 10 plus 2 we get is 12. So this is also not equal to. So this is also end in the error. Let us try with some other number. P is equal to 3. If you substitute this, 5 into 3 plus 2 is equal to 17. Where are we substituting this in the sense? In the same equation. In the equation, there is no change. P is equal to 1, we substitute in the same equation, 2 and 3. All the values what we are going to substitute, it must be in the same equation. There is no change in the equation. Okay. Yes. 5 into 3 plus 2 is equal to 17. 5 3 is 15. 15 plus 2 is equal to 17. So, we got the answer as 17 is equal to 17. Both left hand side and right hand side are equal. Therefore, let us conclude that P is equal to 3 is the solution to the given equation. Next, we'll go on with the second subdivision. 3m minus 14 is equal to 4. Let us try with m is equal to 1. So, in the place of m, you are going to substitute the value of 1. 3 into 1 minus 14 is equal to 4. 3 ones are 3 minus 14 as such will bring down and 4. 3 minus 14 here plus 3 and minus 14. Unlike symbols. This we all know that if it is unlike, what should we do? We should subtract both the numbers and we have to give the greater number sign. Am I right? So 14 minus 3 we get 11, but the symbol here is minus because 14 is the greater number, symbol is minus. So we are going to write minus 11 equal to 4. Is it equal? No, this is not equal. So we should not say that m is equal to 1 is the solution. It is not a solution. Therefore, we are going to try with some other number. Why, ma'am? Let us try with 2, 3, 4, etc. If we go, it will take time for us. So, we should follow some hints in this. What hint we can follow in the sense? It is a clue like if you say minus. Obviously, you check the right answer. You are getting the plus as answer. Am I right? As value is in the positive sign. So, the number what we are going to minus is should be greater than 14. Can you understand my point? If you have a number greater than 14 only, you will get the plus symbol this way. Here, you see 3 is less than 14, so that you get minus. So, what number we are writing here, it should be greater than 14. So, that we will get plus sign here. From third table, why are we saying third table in the sense? 3m is. If you have suppose 5m, you should check with the fifth table. So, here they have given 3. So, you are going to try with third table. In the third table, in 3 ones are 3. If you go on like this, 3 threes are you would get 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15. So from this 15, we can start because 15 is greater than 14. Okay, so we are going to put the value as m is equal to 5. 3 into 5 minus 14 is equal to 4. Nothing else, I have substituted 5 in the place of 3m minus 14 is equal to 4. Instead of m, I am substituting 5. What we have assumed here. So 3 into 5 minus 14 is equal to 4. 3 5s are 15. 15 minus 14 is equal to 4. But we get answer as 1. This is not equal to 4. So this is also not a solution to the given equation. Next we will try with m is equal to 6. If you try with this, what will you get? 3 into 6 minus 14 is equal to 4. 3 6 are 18. 18 minus 14 is equal to 4. Absolutely we get the same answer in both the sides. So here m is equal to 6 is the solution to the given equation. Now we have completed the third question. Let us focus on the fourth question now. Write equations for the following statements. So they have given like statements. We are going to read these statements and we are going to translate the statement into like given equations. Can you see the difference? Third question they have given an equation, but in the fourth question they have given some statements. So what we are going to do, we are going to change this. We are going to write this statement in the form of equations. To write the statement as equation, we should know some tricks in this. We should know some keywords. Like if you get this sum, we should substitute the symbol as plus. So like that, some tricks we have to follow. Let me say this, then it will be easy for you. Let us focus on the keywords. Okay, in the question if you see sum plus increased to, more than, added to, total, after, like this, if you see all these words, we should write the symbol as plus. And if you have like minus, subtracted by, taken away or take away, in decreased to, here you see increased. It is getting more, so we write plus. But here you see decreased. So, it is decreasing. Let us write as minus. So like this, these are the keywords. If you know these keywords, it will be easy for you. Multiplication is very easy. Just a simple words will be there. Times, 2 times, 3 times, 5 times, 10 times. Multiply to, product of. These are the words just that we know already. But what about the word twice and thrice? Have you come across these words? Twice is nothing but 2 times. Thrice this, 3 times. Okay, if you go on with 4 times, 5 times, we'll absolutely write the word as times. This is the short form of the words two times and three times, twice and thrice. Next, division. For division, these are the keywords. Divided by, quotient, one third, not one third alone, one fifth, one tenth, or three fifth, three seventh, five eighth. Okay, just I have given a simple example for that. But if you see like one and third, some 3 and 5th, 3 5th, 7 8th. Such words denotes only the division. Next, fraction of. These are the key words we must focus on these things. If you know all these words, it is easy for us to solve the given questions. Now we know all these key words. Just students, you just pen it down in your paper or a notebook. And just fix it along with your notebook in the particular question. If you go through this again and again, it will be easy for you to solve the questions. Okay, just we'll go on with the fourth question. First subdivision they have given, the sum of numbers x and 4 is 9. In this first, what we should do is, we should focus on the main keyword. The, that is nothing but an article, we'll leave it. Sum of, so first keyword what we got is, sum. These are the numbers. What are the numbers? X and 4. So what we are going to do? We are going to sum X and 4. So the answer is X. What is the symbol for sum? What have we written here? Sum is plus. So X plus 4. Whenever you see this is, we should write equal to. That is the connecting word for the left hand side and the right hand side in the equation. Is, gives, gets, These are the words that is connecting words. Okay. So x plus 4 is equal to what is the number they have given? 9. So that's all, students. This is the equation what to be formed. The next question is 2 subtracted from y is 8. So it is very easy. 2 they have given, just we'll write that number subtracted from. Where we write here subtracted from, it's saying subtracted. What the symbol is? Minus. So let us write 2 minus y is so equal to 8. Now we have written 2 minus y is equal to 8. Do you think is it correct? No, this is not correct because see subtracted from. So from after what we have, that should be the first term. So this is not correct. So what to be written is y should be written first, then you have to write 2. 2 is subtracted from y, that is equal to 8. But for some we have written no x plus 4. It can be written as 4 plus x also because the symbol is never changed here. But when you write subtracted from minus, you should be very conscious with the terms what we write here. Can you understand, students? Shall we go on to the third question now? 10 times a is 70. So times, that is the keyword what we get here. Times is nothing but multiplication. I have shown you already. Times is a keyword of multiplication. So let us write 10 times a. So the answer is 10 into a is 70. We don't want to mention here into. That symbol is not at all needed. Okay. So the answer is you can write as 10a is equal to 70. Okay. Now fourth question. The number b divided by 5 gives 6. I have penned down in a green color. You see that is the keywords what we get. Divided by, that is nothing but the keyword of division. Divided by. So let us write the number b divided by 5. So b is divided by 5. B divided by 5 gives, that is equal to 6. Write the symbol of b and 6 very clearly, students. That is the common mistake that we do in mathematics. Like 2 and z. We should write the correct formation of the number and a variable. The teacher, when they correct, if you commit a mistake in writing, surely you will miss your marks. So be careful with the symbol what you write. Like number should be written as 6. Alphabet should be written as B. Are you clear? Then now the fifth question is 3/4 of T is 15. The key word is 3/4 and is. 3/4 of. So mainly we should focus on 3/4. When we say 3/4, what we should do? Like 3 by 4. We should not write 3 and 4. When you see this 3/4, when you it comes as the remainder. 2/5, 1/7, 5/8. So the last word what we see th, no, it comes as the remainder. 3/4 of t. So 3/4 of t is 15. We can write neatly like this. No, what, how can we write in the sense? 3t by 4 is 15. Next question, sixth question. You see 7 times m plus 7 gets you 77. 7 times. Times is the keyword what we got here. Times, what is the keyword mentioned here? Time is denoted for multiplication. So 7 times m. 7 into m. We can write as 7m plus. Plus is the keyword of addition. So 7m plus 7 gets you. That is nothing but equal to 77. This is the equation for the given statement. Next, seventh question. 1/4 of a number x minus 4 gives 4. So the words what I have written in the black color is the of minus gives. These are the symbols what we are going to write in the equation. 1/4. I have mentioned already in the fifth question. No, when you see the last, it comes as the remainder. So 1/4 of a number x. So x minus 4 gives 4. We can leave it as it is, or else we can write x by 4 minus 4 is equal to 4. Both are correct. We can write in any form. Next, 8th question. If you take away 6 from 6 times y, you get 16. When you see the take away, that is the main keyword here we should focus. What is the keyword for take away? Taken away is given for subtraction. I have mentioned already in the second question, no? You see, the second question we said from. The next term what we write after subtraction should be the first one I said. The same thing we should be focusing here. You see, if you take away 6 from 6 times. So, from. After from what we have got here. 6 times y. This 6 times y, no? That is the main word here. 6 times y. So, 6y. 6y. From 6 times y, taken away 6 from 6 times y, no, so minus 6, you get 16. Have you understood this, students? If you take away 6 from 6 times y, so 6 times y is the word comes after from, that should be written first. 6 times y is 6y, take away, so symbol is minus. What we are going to take away is 6, that 6 we are bringing down as such. So, 6 times y minus 6, that gives 16. Now, we are going to come to the final question, last question of the 4th subdivision. You see, if you add 3 to 1 third of z, you get 30. If you add, so nothing but it is addition. So, we don't want to focus mainly on the terms which should be coming first or second. Addition, you can write as it is, nothing else, no doubt in that. If you add 3 to 1 third of z, so 1 third of z, 1 by 3 of z, add 2, 3, you get 30. So we can write in the standard form like this, z by 3 plus 3 gives 30. Okay, students, so we have solved today. What are the questions have we solved now in this video? Third question, trial and error method, and fourth question, we have converted equation statement to equation. So in the further videos, we'll go on with equation to statements. So stay tuned always to the channel. Before that, don't forget to comment your doubts. Sure, I'll be solving that in the next video. Thank you, students.